then asked, I'm going to put a few questions on the Mughal period. Among the Mughal emperor, whom would you call the greatest, whom the strongest, and whom the most religious emperor? Swami got up. As soon as he was seen, the teacher said emphatically, sit down. Sit down. No, sir, I want to answer. What did I say I would do if you got up again? You said you would cane me and peel the skin off my knuckle and make me press it on my forehead. All right, come here. So what did the teacher say earlier? The teacher only said that he would cane. But he is telling that he had said that he would cane. He had said that he would peel his skin and he would make him press on his forehead. So now Swami was called. The teacher really got irritated and he called Swami. Swaminathan left his seat joyfully and hopped on the platform. Swami was very happy that he was going to get some proof now. And what will be the proof? That he is going to be beaten. The teacher took out his cane from the drawer and shouted angrily, open your hand, you little devil. He wagged three wholesome cuts on each palm. Swami received them without blenching. After half a dozen, the teacher asked, will these do or you want some more? The teacher has given six canes and then he asked, is it okay or you need some more? Just see what he said. Swami merely held out his hand again and received two more. The bell rang. So total Swami got eight canes. Swami jumped down from the platform with a little heart. Though his hands were smarting, he must be feeling pain, but his hands were smarting. Why his hands were smarting? Because his hands were the proof to justify his father's letter. He picked up his books, took out the letter lying in his pocket and ran to the headmaster's room. He found the door closed. Now he was very happy. He ran towards the headmaster's chamber, but what he saw? He saw the room was closed. He asked the PM, where is the headmaster? Why do you want him? My father has sent a letter to him. So he asked PM, where is the headmaster? PM inquired, why did he need him? He said that his father has sent a letter. He has taken afternoon off and won't come back for a week. You can give the letter to the assistant headmaster. He will be there now. Who is he? Your teacher Samuel. He will be here in a second. So what did the PN suggest? PN suggested him to give the letter to the assistant headmaster. And who was the assistant headmaster? Assistant headmaster was Samuel himself. Swaminathan fled from the place. As soon as Swami went home, with the letter, father remarked, I knew you wouldn't deliver it, you coward. Swami's father called him coward. But do you know what is the meaning of coward? Darpok. Actually, he was not darpok, but as he had made this type of impression was made, so his father considered him as a coward. I swear, our headmaster is on leave, Swaminathan began. Now Swaminathan wanted to say that the headmaster was on leave. Father replied, don't lie in addition to being a coward. Father said that you are a coward, that I know. Now don't be a liar. Swami held up the envelope and said, I will give this letter to the headmaster as soon as he is back. Father snatched it from his hand, tore it up and thrust it into waste paper basket under his table. He muttered, "Don't come to me for help, even if Samuel you deserve your Samuel."